Petra, how did it go? I'm for internationalrallynews.com. How did it go?
Yeah,
it's really well. Yeah? Jari, how did it go? Yeah, you happy? Nasser, how did it go? Good? Happy?
Tomorrow, and all the drivers are now coming up. Nasser, Mads, Mikko, everybody is here. Fastest in the qualifying this morning was Petter Solberg, second fastest, Jari-Matti Latvala, Sebastian Loeb, and Mikko Hirvonen's already causing problems by mixing up the numbers. So there's always something with him. But as we said, first on the road, first to pick, sorry, not first on the road, but first to pick is Petter Solberg. Now this weekend there's a bit of iffy weather coming in, the road clean's really, really good, so where do you pick? Do you go with the weather at the front? Or do you go further back and have the cleaning effect done for you? Well, we're about to find out, because we're going to call Petter Solberg up first of all. And I don't know what he's doing now. He's leaning over. Petter, obviously, quickest first. You need to sign that, and then you need to place that on our board. Okay, number four, it says. It's magnetic. There we go. It's signed. Hey! You've got position 1 to 14, Petter. Come on, let the world know. Petter picking 14th. Petter, the last car of the World Rally Cars. What's the reasoning behind that? You're hoping the weather's going to be good?
I can sleep a little bit longer in the morning.
You can, yeah.
No, I think it's the best position for cleaning, and if it's raining, it's dry up quickly, so I think it will be good. I'm in top form, and the car and the team is in top form, so I hope this is our rally now.
So I think a lot of people out there do as well. So Petter picks 40. Next up is Jari-Matti Latvala. Now, obviously, we've got to look after this guy this weekend because he's still recovering from the collarbone injury, but apparently it's fine because it's the left one, which apparently makes such a difference. Okay, Jari. Second pick. I got a feeling I know where you're going. Okay. Jari, Petter saying there that the team are in a strong position. The last two places on the road. Everything's in your hands now.
Yeah, it's we are starting from the behind, so we are counting that it will be dry rally. Usually this rally is a hot rally. Now the weather has been a little bit strange, but still we are counting on that. It's going to be dry, so I think it's the road will be cleaning, and that's why we are starting from behind.
Okay, third quickest is Mr. Loeb. So Sebastian signs the sheet. I got a feeling this is going to be quite predictable from now on. Seven.
I tell you what, Seb, I thought that was actually going on there. They're magnetic, so once that had stuck, you wouldn't have been able to change. But 12th, best place to be from your position?
Yeah, it was just a joke for Petter, but that's because he was looking what I do. But
I was looking at what you were doing.
Yeah, but yes, we expect not a lot of rain on the rally, so it will be cleaning, and then we prepare to be behind.
Okay, next one up is Evgeny Novikov, fourth quickest in qualifying. Evgeny is signing his name, and I got a feeling this is going to go in number 11, I think. You just stick it, yep. Okay, Evgeny goes 11th. It's pretty obvious you were going to go there. Evgeny, happy with that?
Yeah, I'm happy. Nothing special. So, as back as possible, that's all.
Okay, right, next one up. Mikko Hirvonen didn't have the greatest qualifying run. Wasn't great at the start. He said a little mistake in the middle of the stage. Unfortunately for him, I think it's going to be 10th unless he surprises us all. No, he's not going to surprise us all. I didn't think so. Unfortunately, you can't do that. Okay, Mikko. Whoa! Okay, Mikko's very strong. He's just knocked the port over. Mikko, that mistake in qualifying has basically cost you a couple of positions on the road.
Yeah, maybe, but okay, we are not too far away from the, you know, Petter and Jari-Matti and Sebastian, so it's a long way to go, so I should be all right.
Okay, next up, Thierry Neuville in the stage. Running further down in the qualifying stage, and the softer tyres maybe not being the optimum choice because the stage was drying out a bit. But Thierry posting 6th quickest time. Go on, surprise us, Thierry. Do something different. Oh, apparently it's very easy where he's going to go. That's it, Thierry Neuville. Obviously 9th on the road then for tomorrow. Thierry, you happy with that?
Yeah, quite happy. Okay, I think could a little bit better, maybe one place, but night on the road, it's not so bad, and let's see tomorrow.
Okay, let's see tomorrow. Next up was Mads Osberg. Now this man, when he got to the end of the stage, saw the times of the top runners and told me he doesn't know how they went 5 seconds quicker than him. He was absolutely astounded and shocked. And potentially, for a regular podium finisher so far this year, it wasn't the best run for him. Mads, you were slightly confused by that time and you're going 8th tomorrow.
Yeah, but okay, the position on the road is not so bad, and the real rally starts tomorrow, so hopefully the position is okay and we can fight back.
Okay, we will see you then. Next up is number 5, Ait Tanak. Now Ait had a bit of a problem. He actually did finish the stage, but he had a broken front right steering arm after clipping a tree in the final couple of corners. But he did post the stage time, which I think is a very, very fortunate for him. He was very relieved to get through the flying finish and the stop control. But Ait Tanak takes 7th on the road. Ait, you'll be pleased with that after the problems in those final couple of 100 meters?
For sure not. It would be much better, but okay. It's longer off rally, so we just need to keep it going now.
Okay, Ait needs a little bit of luck, to be fair. Okay, next up is Martin Prokop. Here we are, Martin. The only one not in overalls. Well, look at this, the only one not in overalls. Martin, you need to sort yourself out next time. On the back of some great couple of rallies, top 5 finishes for him in the last couple, and I suspect he's going to go 6th. Look at that. Oh, it's not quite straight. Look at that. Oh, man. Martin, obviously last couple of rides have been really good for you. Another potential weekend of good results?
Yeah, I hope so. Every race we start in the middle of the starting. So, again like this, so hopefully it will be good.
Hopefully it will be. Nasser Alatea, 10th quickest. Woo! Nasser clipping the big rock.
Nasser!
Too much of a cut. Clipping a big rock and damaging the front left wheel, which gave him 10th fastest. Obviously a man used to rough, long stages with his Dakar thing. I tell you what, someone just give us a bit of a change, a bit of a surprise. It ain't going to be Nasser, is it?
Hey!
Nasser, that little moment you had in there, do you think it cost you a couple of positions?
Yes, actually, you know, we hit the one rock and we have a flat tire, but okay. We lose a little bit time, but today will be first stage, 25 kilometers, we try to do our best. And yeah, we must enjoy this race.
Okay, we'll look forward to seeing you. Next up is Daniel Oliveira in the Ford Fiesta Bug running car. Now, I didn't actually speak to Daniel.
Thank you. ouais, c'est très bien.
Ça nous est déraillé.
Vous me voyez quoi? Peut-être.
Thank you.
Rallynews.com. How is everything going?
Good, good. Going very good.
Yes? You are happy?
Yes.
Everything improving?
Everything.
I'm very happy for you, man.
Thank you so much.
Go ahead, man. Best of luck, eh?
Okay.
From internationalrallynews.com. How's everything going today? A little bit better than yesterday?
I don't know. We just done one stage so far and it was quite alright. So we'll see.
But no,
it's be
but no problems.
Not on that.
Also. Okay. Okay, that's fine. Maîtrise.
Trying to beat him, Bessie. I think we might well follow him, but I'd have to say, having dragged that for the best part of the whole stage.
Nesta, Ares, WRC. Δέκατη θέση της γενικής κατάταξης και πολύ όμορφες κοπέλες της ΕΚΟ είναι κοντά μας για να πάρουν τα βραβεία τους. Χειροκροτήστε τους! Είναι οι πρώτοι ιδιώτες WRC. Δεξί, Μπάκετ, φέτος οδηγεί ένα Volkswagen Skoda Fabia Super 2000. Είναι πρώτη στην κατηγορία των Super 2000. Φιλοκροτήστε τους, πρώτοι και καλύτεροι. Μπράβο. Σεβαστιάν Ουσιέ. Και η Γκρασία, Γιουλία Γκρασία. Τσούλη. Για το πλήρωμα από το Βέλγιο, κύριε Νεβίλ και Νικολά Κιούτσι. Σιτουέν. Νεβίλ και Κιούτσι. Πρώτα από την Τσεχία με ένα Ford Fiesta RS WRC. WRC.
Best performance ever in Rani Acropolis. So I did a little mistake. One running a little bit wide and I got the control. So I broke the rim as well later on stage. And then we had to stop because we lost the rear brakes and had to change the tire and quite a little bit of brake take what was after that. But at the end of the rally, I hear me on the podium. That's what I said is good after my sick leave with my shoulder. I enjoy the rally a lot. It's been a different Acropolis this year. Normally it's been very hot over here and dry, but this year it's been a little bit wet and muddy. But it's good to have some different kind of third place is, you know, that the overall is not the same.
Mira Pablo, con las metimos así cabrón.
Ο Λέρης Μακελιάς ήταν σίγουρο ότι ήταν μέχρι να δει και συγκεκριμένως καλά τον αγώνα από την Αφέλη το ράλι, ήταν μέχρι να έχει την πρώτη θέση.
Καλύτερους του 58ου ράλι Ακρόπολης. Οι φετινοί νικητές είναι ο Σεβαστιάν Λεπ και ο Ντανιέλ Ελένα.
Μετά το πρόβλημα του Σόλβερτ σήμερα το πρωί, φοβήθηκε βέβαια. Αργότερα θα γεννήθηκε και ένα μικρό πλατάρισμα, αλλά τελικά όλα καλά. Πήρε την τρίτη νίκη στην καριέρα της στην Ελλάδα.
Παρακαλώ πολύ λοιπόν. Να έρθει κοντά μας ο Δήμαρχος Λεκρατίου και Περαφόρας, ο κύριος Κώστας Λογοθέτης, για την απονομή του τρίτου πληρώματος. Ελλήνων Προλόγων. Κύριε Δήμαρχε, θα τα λέει για τους τρίτους, παρακαλώ. Διάρρημα του Γκλάντουαλα, μη καλύλα. Το όπλο του Ford Fiesta RS WRC, στην τρίτη θέση της Γενικής Κατάταξης. Χειροκροτήστε τους. Παρακαλώ πολύ για την απονομή στους δεύτερους νικητές του 58ου Ράλι Ακρόπολης, τον Δήμαρχο Αθηναίων, τον κύριο Γιώργο Καμίνη, να έρθει για την απονομή. Δεύτερο λοιπόν της Γενικής Κατάταξης, Μίκο Χίρκονεν και Γιάρμο Λέπινεν, με Citroën DS3 WRC. Παρακαλώ πολύ τον Πρόεδρο της Οργανωτικής Επιτροπής του 58ου Ράλι Ακρόπολης, κύριο Βασίλη Δεσποτόπουλο, να έρθει για την απονομή στους νικητές της φετινής χρονιάς. Σεβαστιάν Λεπ και Ντανιέλ Ελένα. παρακαλώ πολύ από τον εκπρόσωπο της ομάδας, Ζαβιέ Εστελάν, να έρθει κοντά μας για να παραλάβει το βραβείο του κατασκευαστή. Παρακαλώ πολύ τον κύριο Βραχάτη, Διευθυντή Επικοινωνίας του Hotel και Δημοσίων Σχέσεων του Hotel Καζίνο Λιτράκη, να έρθει κοντά μας για να κάνει την απονομή. Ευχαριστώ πολύ. Λοιπόν, πάμε λοιπόν για να ακούσουμε τους εθνικούς ύμνους, μάλλον ένας θα είναι, γιατί τόσο το πλήρωμα είναι από τη Γαλλία, όσο και κατασκευαστής επίσης είναι από τη Γαλλία. Κυρίες και κύριοι, ο γαλλικός εθνικός ύμνος. Μια φορά, οι τρεις καλύτεροι του φετινού 58ου Ράλι Ακρόπολης. Μπράβο τους!